may not have changed the landscape of grand cinema, but it has affected the people who are interested in cinema, if not the general public. Because I can give you instances, like, you know, when I started this in 2006, when I was in Suchitra Film Society, we had hardly 600 delegates. We are screening in two cinema houses. And today, it's more than 6,000 people in 11 screens, and all are full generally. We stop actually registration of some particular time because we can't take more than 6,000 or 7,000 delegates. A couple of filmmakers have told me that they became filmmaker because of the BIFFes. The holistic approach of cinema is presented in a film festival. Even though the screening part of it is essentially focused on intellectual understanding of cinema. But we also give all the elements of cinema. We discuss all the elements of cinema in any film festival, like the technological growth, like the different ways of exhibiting cinema today has changed, that we are bringing into focus. We're also bringing into economics of cinema. Now, KGF is one cinema which showed that present trend in the world cinema. If you look at even European cinema, each cinema is a co-production. Each cinema is multilingual. Each cinema is, because you can't sustain with one single market. Therefore, in Kannada, there's a new awareness through KGF that there's a possibility that it can sustain an economic, framework also. Why Indian cinema is not globally present in film festivals in as much as it should is that because there is a problem with making of cinema in this country. Tithi is one film which was very conscious of filmmaking. It took almost 2 years to see that, you know, if you look at their sound design, there is a concept of sound design in Tithi. There is a concept of visual design in that. It is not that the rural characters, you have taken their photograph just going into that village. Whole thing, each and every frame has been planned. Therefore, there is lot of things that has gone into making up that cinema has not been done for, you know, so many people come to me and ask me, sir, I also want to make a film like Tithi. I ask them how much budget you have. They say about 15 lakhs, 20 lakhs. I said Tithi costed him 2 crores. It is not that making of a film, construction of a film is by itself is a skill. You need to have both skill and creativity simultaneously in cinema. Tithi, it became very important, it became very popular because it had the elements of both skill and creativity. Most of the films we see as art films, the problem with them, they have good content. We are a very old civilization, we got so many stories to tell. I always keep telling anyway in all forums that India has so many things to tell you. But they'll all ask me is, where are the people who can tell the stories in the right format? No, I think I've not put this kind of as a commercial and entertainment as the parameter. Because that gives us some sort of hierarchical lookout. It is not that. Like any media, for example, language itself. You see, language we use it for normal communication. Language we use it at home is different. Language we use it in your journalism is different. Language used in literature is different. Even in literature, if it is used in essay, it is different. If it is used in poetry, it is different. Therefore, every media has its multi-purpose usages. Or I would say it as the variants of use of a language. There are different variants of use of a language. Similarly, there are the variants of using this medium. As I said, some people use it as a commercial proposition. But they can't just make it only commercial pop. They have to put some content into that. Where did that content come from? Sociologically, if you look at it, that content comes from your contemporary society, particularly cinema, particularly visual culture. It has to be always contemporary culture. Then there is cinema comes into this middle level where we are saying, you know, in Kannada we say, like, you know, Putana Kanaga, or Dr. Rajkumar's films, you can't just categorize them as entertainment. There is a cultural value, you know, put ingrained into that. It is. We have two sections. It's not just one only Kannada popular entertainment. We have another section. As I said, the 68 films had come. There's another section. Some of those films do get into international competitions. Like, you know, we have for all the three sections, we have Asian cinema, Indian cinema, and Kannada cinema. In all these three segments, we have international juries. In these international juries, the films that pass through these international juries, Kannada cinema also, sometimes they move out to different film festivals. Last 3 years, the films which have won award in our international jury award in Bangalore festival have made it to festivals in other Asian zones. It is not that, even now it is not there. As I said, I keep telling that this, we focus more on making of cinema, the construction of cinema, we need to focus. We need to train our youngsters, they develop the skills of filmmaking in a bigger way. Then you have all the chances of getting into all the festivals.